Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This video is part of a course called as CCA Data Analyst in which HiveScoop and Impala are covered quite extensively. If you want to learn any of these technologies or prepare for the certification, you can enroll for our course for $10 by going through the information in description. Also, we provide something called as Big Data Developer Labs. If you want to sign up for the labs and practice, you can actually go to the description and click on the link to get details about the labs. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and also click on notify button so that you get notified whenever we create free content as part of our channel. Let us explore functions such as reverse and concatenate. So reverse just reverses the data. You can actually get the description for the reverse function by saying describe function reverse. It just reverses the string. There is nothing fancy about it. Even though it is not very apparent, it is a very powerful performance tuning tool in traditional RDBMSs. Sometimes when we actually store the ID for a given organization, there will be organization code in the beginning and then the followed with ID. If you just store the data as is and if you want to search for first few characters, as the first few characters are same across all the records, it will perform a full index scan if the column is indexed, which is not good. Instead of doing that, what we tend to do is we reverse the values and we then store into the database. So in the database, the values will be stored in the reverse fashion. And then whenever there is a query from the front end, that value will be reversed and then compared with this indexed column, and the index scan will be much more appropriate. So even though reverse doesn't sound very obvious, it is very powerful performance tuning tool in some of the scenarios. And hence we use reverse quite a bit in traditional RDBMSs as well as the data warehouses. To use reverse function, it's pretty straightforward. Let's say there is a string called hello world. If you want to reverse, you just have to apply reverse on top of it and it will be reversed for you. Now you can see that data is reversed as expected. Now let us see how we can concatenate two strings. In RDBMSs like Oracle, there is an operator called as double pipe like this, which can be used to concatenate. So if I have to concatenate hello and world, if it is Oracle, I can say select hello space and then concatenate with world. And then we say from dual like this, and we should be able to concatenate. However, that is not a valid operator here. We have to use a function called as concat or concatenate. We can actually say describe function. I think the function name is concatenate, not concat. Let us see. Yeah, it is concat only. I think there is a function called as concatenate also. Let us see. So function concatenate does not exist. So it is concat only. So when it comes to concat, you can actually pass as many strings as you want, and you should be able to concat. So in this case, I just have to say select hello and then world semicolon and hit enter. Here I did not specify concat, that's why it failed. So let me specify concat here and hit enter. Now hello world are concatenated. However, if you want to concatenate with a field value with a string, it is pretty straightforward. We can say select concat order status is and then order underscore status from orders underscore part and then limit 10. So orders underscore part is my partition table, which is not transactional. Orders is bucketed table, which is transactional, and hence I will not be able to use orders unless I set transaction related properties. For that reason, I am using orders underscore part for this demo. And we should be able to see the order status concatenated with order status is. This is how you should be able to concatenate with a constant string with the column values. Also, earlier we have seen that there can be a scenario where the dates are separated in the form of year field, month field, and date field within the database. If that is the case, we want to just concatenate these three values and rebuild the date. So to demonstrate that, I will just say select star from, and then I'll nest this query. Using union, you can actually add as many as you want. So if you just want to come up with an exercise where you have multiple rows, you can use an operator called as union, and you should be able to union multiple rows like this. And then you can nest those values and query as part of select star from. So it will create a temporary table and on which you should be able to perform the exercises. For now, I'm not getting into those details. I'm just passing one query here. When it comes to Hive, we have to provide alias for the nested subqueries, and hence I'm giving alias called as Q and hit enter. Now it has returned these three values for this one record. I want to concatenate these three values and rebuild the date, and I want to use hyphen as the character while concatenating these three values so that I can actually rebuild the date in yyyy-mm-dd format. So the way you can do it is, here you can use concat. As part of the concat, you can get the year and then this hyphen, because we have to concat a literal,
And then we can actually say lpad month. It has to be two characters. If it is not two characters, then I want to lpad with 0. So that's why I said lpad month comma 2 comma 0. And then again, I want to concatenate with hyphen. And then I want to lpad my date with 0 if it is less than 2 characters. And then close the bracket for concat. We can give the alias as date, or let's say order date. And then I can say from, then the nested query, which is nothing but this one. Now you can hit enter, and the date is rebuilt. So instead of 2013 July 25th, let us check with 2014 January 8th. So here I just have to use the same logic for this select and function. However, when it comes to the query in the from clause, which is nothing but a nested query, I just have to refactor to 1 for the month to represent January and 8 for the date. Now the date is rebuilt as 2013 January 8th. If it is 2014, I just have to change the year also to 2014. That's it. So this is how we can actually get the dates rebuilt if the dates are separated into three fields, such as year, month, and date. It is very common in data warehouses where there will be a date ID, month ID, and year ID. And as part of the date ID, we store dates. As part of the month ID, we store months. As part of the year ID, we store years. And to rebuild and represent the date as is, we have to use this approach of concatenating all the three values. However, as they are integers, we need to lpad with zeros so that January through September and also dates from 1st to 9th are represented properly. So this is how you can actually use the concat to concat multiple strings. In this case, we have used the lpad function also while concatenating with the columns and also literals such as hyphen. So this is a bit advanced usage of concat operator along with the usage of other functions and also the values from the columns as well as literals such as hyphen.